The wreckage of Colin Francis's plane was found after an investigation by members of Tunbridge Aircraft Preservation Society. It was his first mission and his last. The aircraft had dived almost vertically into the ground. Colin was identified only by an inscribed watch found nearby. The recovery of the wreckage finally cleared up a mystery which had remained unsolved for 41 years. Retired Group Captain Tom Gleave had flown alongside Colin Francis on the day he died.
We've been looking for him for, I suppose, 40 years now, and no signs, no clues. The squadron took off with the squadron leader. I was an interloper, allowed to stay with the squadron. I'd handed over, and the squadron took off. 20 minutes later, I had the emergency flight, three of us, and we were sent up to intercept a very large formation traveling from the London direction towards Dover. Unknown to me only a few seconds before, Brown on my right, now Group Captain Brown, he'd seen an ME-109 very close and turned to fire, and he was fired on from behind. And he got away with it, he bailed out and he was wounded, but he's all right. Came back to fight again. Colin came in with me, he was on my left, I saw him on my left as we went into this, like a huge grill of ME-109. There was some underneath too, operating independently in pairs. And that was the last time we saw Colin Francis. This was his baptism.
His first engagement?
Yes, and it was bad luck he was killed. He could have got away with it. Being a young chap, much more lithe than an older fellow, or not as experienced, per se, in firing. But he was just unlucky. When you're young like that, you're willing to take a chance. Colin, I'm sure, was willing to take a chance. You know, it's a young man's ambition to go out and do something great. And I mean, what he did on that day, it could have been VC stuff. If he'd survived, shot a few down.